What is going on, everyone? It is Mike. Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to talk about tools that make tech videos better. Now, when I first seen this, I thought this was probably one of the silliest things in the world. $120 for essentially a colored sheet of paper. Well, this is probably one of the few purchases that you essentially need if you want to do any type of color correction, color balancing, and you want to make your videos look really good, because you could see there's a lot of colors in this video. You want to make sure that they're accurate as can be and they don't shift the colors of your video. So in today's video, I'm going to tell you how to use this X-Rite Color Checker. I'm going to show you how I use it inside of Final Cut Pro. And at the end, we'll talk about how you could use it in your next video. Let's get started. Now, when I was first introduced to this, I thought it was something that I didn't need. $120 for the X-Rite Color Checker. You can buy it on any number of websites, Amazon, B&H, and I'll put links down in the description below in case you want to find it. But this is something that you want to make sure that you have with you on every video shoot, because what you're going to do essentially is you're going to put it next to the talent. Whoops. And you're going to put it in front of their face like this. And you're going to make sure that all of the colors are showing in clearly inside the image, which we know that it is. Now, if I had a second camera today, I would actually turn towards that second camera and I would make sure that, you know, my face is shown in that second camera. And then I would turn back here. Now let's bring this footage over to Final Cut Pro and show you how it works. So I've imported all of my clips into Final Cut here, and I've actually synchronized one of the clips. And here I'm just going to skim the clip. Let me mute my audio, mute my system audio. And if we look here, go to fill. So I'm going to put my marker here just so I know where I'm working inside of the clip. And I'm going to cut this clip on both sides. And what I'm going to do first is I'm going to apply a mask. And that mask is going to allow me to selectively identify what I want to match in that clip. So in Final Cut, you go to Video. It's called the Effects. Yeah, it's called Effects. Then you go to Mask. Here we are. And then I do Draw Mask. So I'm going to throw the draw mask right on top. Now, once I've added the mask to it, I'm going to add my control points, but I actually want to work in a little bit larger of a screen. So I'm going to go to my workspaces, and I've set up a default workspace for color and white balance. I have one for when I have one screen, just using my computer by itself, and the other one I'm using two monitors, which is going to be this one right here. So I have that screen pulled up. I'm going to minimize my timeline, and I'm basically going to put my control points around this square. Doesn't need to be perfect, but it does need to be around this rectangle. And if you could see here, if I'm looking at this rectangle, that's the only thing that's shown in the picture. So it's these six colors. And those actually map to the colors that are here in this Vectorscope. So the Vectorscope is a visual representation of the colors and their intensity that map to your image that you're looking at on your screen. Now you could see here the yellow, it's not necessarily dead center of the yellow line. Neither is the red is actually pretty good. But the magenta is way off. The blue is way off. Cyan is way off. And then there's this line right here, which is called the skin tone line. And everyone's skin tone, whether it's you, me, or anybody else, is going to fall on that skin tone line. Now that is not used right now, but I'll show you how we use that. I'm going to click on the color inspector, and then I'm going to go to this no corrections. I'm going to go to hue saturation curves. And what a hue saturation curve is, it allows me to get the dropper and I say, I want to find this color, which is cyan, along the curve. Now, if I look at the cyan is right here. So it's dramatically off. Let's just kind of show you. So now you could really see how far off each of these colors are. So if I go to cyan and I raise the saturation, if I push it down, it then gets perfectly calibrated with the middle of the cyan. Now you don't have to necessarily be in the middle of the square here, but you could be anywhere, I would say, in the general vicinity, and you should be okay. And now you see that color change. Now, if I were to pull this down, see how it's going from cyan colored and it's getting more blue. And if I keep going down, it's gonna get more purple, and then it's gonna start impacting the other colors in there. So I'm gonna just make sure it's perfectly straight along that line. If I wanted to, I could make this window bigger so I could have a little bit more, it's a granularity. I'm going to pull down these curves here. Now I'm going to go to magenta because magenta is way off. All right, so there's magenta and it's spot on. Same thing, I'm going to add a control point on each side of magenta just to make sure that I'm not impacting the other colors. And while I'm doing this, I'm actually on my keyboard, I'm holding down the command key and then using my mouse to push up or push down on this. That's how you're going to change it. Yellow is not too bad, but still off. Pull down like that. Okay, you don't really have to do anything there. We're just going to go down the line, clicking here. Red, Red is not too bad. All right, I'm gonna go green. Green is pretty good. And this is just a reflection of my environment. So all these colors were present in the environment and they changed the way that these color chips showed. Now I'm gonna hit blue and I'm gonna pull that there. So now you can see each of these colors are all perfectly straight, but they're way oversaturated. So if I were to go to the effects panel and then turn off the mask, you could see like I'm way oversaturated, completely oversaturated. It looks like I've been sitting in the sun all day long or I've been fake baking for, you know, 6 months straight. Now I'm gonna go back and turn on the draw mask. And I'm gonna go back to my color correction panel and I'm gonna turn down the saturation to what it was beforehand. And now you can see here each of these colors. So you can see the saturation here is a little bit strong for cyan, a little bit strong for yellow. It really depends on your personal preference. You could change that if you wanted to, depending on the look that you're trying to go for. But what I'm gonna do next is I'm going to click on the draw mask and then I'm gonna make sure that I'm white balanced. Now that's the other benefit of having this this chart here. You could use this to white balance your scene. So now instead of clicking automatic, I'm gonna click on white balance and I'm gonna click on this very bottom square, which is the whitest part in the color checker card. Now let's go to this, go to draw mask. Now if I turn this off, let's go to a, so we're not zoomed in on my head. Now if I turn that off, let's see what the progression looks like. So here we see this is the, you know, the room. First thing I would do is do the color balance color, and then you see a lot of the color comes in. Then I would do the hue saturation curves, and now the colors map correctly. And you could see the change here in the Vectorscope. Before, after, before, after. And this Vectorscope is a visual representation of this. So this strong purple line should be this TV here in the back. And if I turn this off, yeah, you could see how it changes the color purple here. This red should be somewhere, maybe my head if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, see, look, here's color balanced and color matched. Not. Big difference.
And if you guys like this type of content, consider hitting subscribe, turning on notifications, and if you like this type of content and you want to see more of it, let me know that by hitting the like button down below. Now, back to the edit.
Now, what I'm going to show you next is going to be the skin tone line. I'm going to copy my effects from that scene to the next scene. I'm going to paste them. And now I know that this scene is the same. Actually, I need to go just a little bit farther back. Just hitting Command-Z to go backwards here. I'm going to paste it all the way. And what I'm doing here is I'm looking for a place where my face is shown. So this would be a good one. So I'm in focus and there. Now I'm going to go to the draw mask. I'm going to turn it back on. You see, obviously, the draw mask doesn't have my face selected. I'm going to reset it. And I'm basically just going to draw the control points around my face. Doesn't need to be perfect, but it does need to be around your face and what's in focus. Now we see here, here's the skin tone line. I always forget that now. Skin tone indicator, that's the correct name. And if you see here, I am on the line, obviously, because everyone is, but I'm more going towards the red. Now I'm gonna add another layer of hue saturation curves, and I'm gonna do the same medicine dropper. Go to window, workspaces, go to... And if you're not comfortable looking at yourself this closely, well, you'll need to get used to it. And we see here, now here's that color in that picture. I'm gonna pull that close. Let's get this, pull this down. I'm gonna look at that nice and bright or nice and big. Now, if I move these lines, that line gets narrower and you really wanna be as narrow of a line as possible because as this line fans out more, the colors are less accurate for this, for your skin tone. And obviously you don't wanna have red skin or blue skin. If you see here, if I take this marker here, if I pull down the red, you'll look at my lips. They start changing colors. So that's definitely not right. So I want to make it as narrow as possible. And then I'm going to continue to adjust these. See, if I pull this way, I'm yellow. I want that line to be as narrow as possible, but not any narrower. Go back to the scene, go to the draw mask and turn it off. You can see that the red in my cheeks, which isn't necessarily incorrect, but it is an effect of the camera. Right, so now I have that looking correct. If I wanted to maybe add just a little bit more saturation to my face, I would go here and I would go from the hue versus hue, which is, you know, mapping out the hue colors, and go to the saturation. I click in roughly the same place and I could adjust the saturation of each of these colors individually. So I could go real high or I could just do it kind of incrementally. You can see here, I think I just might have changed this a little bit. There we go. I could leave this alone, and I could actually just change the saturation of all the colors, which may or may not be what you're looking for depending on your scene and what you're shooting for. If I hit Command 0, that should bring me back to this very first. All right, and if I go to my effects panel, if I turn off the draw mask and I look at this scene, so here it is with zero effects on it. I've color balanced it, I've color corrected it, and now I've color corrected my skin tone as well. And if you go from here to here, big difference, big, big difference. Now that is why the X-Rite Color Checker is gonna be critical for you if you are shooting videos, color correcting videos. You wanna make sure that you have people that are using this because it's gonna make sure that you don't waste your time setting up lights, setting up camera. You know, if you're an independent creator, it takes you a long time to do all that anyways, but if you have a team, that costs a lot of money. So you wanna make sure that you are doing this as much as possible and as consistently as possible so your clips look consistent. You're using the same attention to detail in each of those clips. Let me know if you have any questions below. That's gonna do it for me today. My name is Mike. This is Tech 24/7 TV. Guys, I will talk to you in the next one.